Hey friends, some things in the Azure marketplace are really easy to provision, such as your container image or your favorite CMS, but others can require more complex and time-consuming workflows. So Microsoft is working with select SaaS providers to simplify that experience and offer deeper integration with Azure. Ramya is here to show me how easy and quick it is to provision Confluent Cloud resources from Azure today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Ramya and we're going to talk about the Confluent Cloud on Azure. How are you?
I'm doing good, Scott. Thanks for having me on your show. How are you doing?
I'm very well and I'm thrilled to be chatting with you because I'm going to learn about new ways to make more choices for developers. I know that a lot of work has been done in Azure to make it so that when I want to have a relationship with another company, maybe in the Azure marketplace, that process, that sign up and that management experience is smoother than ever.
Yes, Scott. So let me give you some background on the program. So the Azure offers a rich set of capabilities and services, but we're always looking for ways to provide more choice, ease of use, and delightful experiences. So we work with popular SaaS providers whose products are heavily used by customers. So we build a seamless integration layer between Azure and the SaaS offerings to enable users to quickly and easily manage and provision SaaS resources from Azure client interfaces. So we have launched such an integration with Confluent Cloud, a popular SaaS provider for fully managed Apache Kafka for event streaming.
That's pretty cool. So how would I have organized this before? Would I have to like make my own virtual machines and my own compute and install all of this? Or would I have to go to the Confluent people and work with them separately?
Yes. Previously, things were different, and we've added and introduced a lot of features within the integration layer. So let me talk about more, in fact, about the real-time streaming here. So the urgency for real-time streaming is growing exponentially and will continue to grow as companies digitally transform. And real-time infrastructure would be running at the core, like a central nervous system, processing large volumes of data at scale, reliably, and in a persistent way. So let me share some of the customer learnings we've had. So customers often face challenges when building and managing this real-time infrastructure due to the management overhead. Rather, they would like to focus on their end customer problems and focus on business innovation. And customers who have dependencies on SaaS providers and Azure face challenges with managing and maintaining these resources and an account separately in Azure and in the SaaS offering. So take, for example, user account creation. So they would need to undergo an entire separate sign-up process, need approvals from multiple stakeholders, and this would extend the project timelines and also introduce certain complexities during the audit process. So such customers would like to use these SaaS resources as part of overall Azure solution in a single window clearance. And more importantly, we've also seen customers using Confluent Cloud to stream data from on-premise systems like mainframes into the Azure services. And they would like this or need the entire Kafka system to be closer to the Azure services for various latency and performance reasons.
That's a great point that you make, that this wants to be in the same region as close as possible to where the data is being produced and where the data is going to be looked at. So by having this, you know, this Azure resource be treated as a real Azure resource makes a huge difference for customers.
Right. There are customers from telecom, finance, healthcare, and more importantly, we have seen large retail customers using Confluent Cloud to process trillions of messages per month.
Wow.
So with so much, yeah. So with so much happening in the space, Microsoft and Confluent have worked together to build a seamless integration layer between Azure and Confluent Cloud. This enables users to quickly and easily provision and manage the Confluent Cloud resources from Azure client interfaces like CLI, SDK, PowerShell, and Azure Portal. And customers can also leverage their existing Azure commits to consume and procure Confluent Cloud subscriptions. And they can view the consumption of Confluent Cloud resources in their monthly Azure bill.
Very cool.
So let me show you things in action, how easy it is to create Confluent Cloud resources from Azure.
All right, I can see your screen.
Yes, so go to the Azure portal and then go to the Azure Marketplace storefront and look for the offer, Apache Kafka and Confluent Cloud. This essentially turns two offers here. One is a Confluent platform and the Apache Kafka and Confluent Cloud. So the Confluent platform is the solution template. And now I'm going to click on the Apache Kafka, which is a SaaS offer. And here we are in the service page. So users can review the service information and the plans and pricing available, right? And I'm going to click on set up and subscribe to create to get started and create the Confluent Cloud resources. So first choose an Azure subscription where you have owner or contributor access. And then choose a resource group. You can either choose a resource group or create a new one. Now let's give a name to this resource. So we're now going to create the top level Confluent Cloud resource, which is called Confluent Organization. Right, so we're going to choose a region to deploy this Confluent Organization, and users will still have the flexibility to deploy the Kafka clusters in the Azure supported regions, and I'm going to show that in a bit. To choose a plan, the pay-as-you-go plan here, and click on tags to create the tags, and I'm going to choose the or type the key value pair here. And proceed to review and create. So here we can review the inputs given and click on create. So once the resource gets submitted for deployment, it takes couple of minutes for the resource to get created. So in the interest of time, I've already created a resource and let's take a look at it. So once a resource gets created, it is available in the resource group along with your other Azure resources. And on clicking on the resource, here we are on the resource overview page. And if you see the resource group, the location and the subscription is mapped to a Confluent Cloud resource. Now let me click on Manage on Confluent Cloud to single sign on to the Confluent Cloud service. Like I mentioned earlier, the Azure AD credential is used to single sign on to the Confluent Cloud service. And this avoids the complexity of maintaining a separate account for Confluent and the overhead of managing the separate accounts. So here we are in the Confluent Cloud service. And now let me show you how to create the cluster. So click on add cluster and you see options here, basic, standard, and dedicated. Now I'm going to choose basic. And the differences between these three clusters is more about the service limits and some of the security and networking features that are available in the dedicated cluster. So I'll click on begin configuration. And here, like I mentioned, users can create multiple clusters and they can choose the region from the supported regions here. Right, so I'm gonna choose East US here and click on continue. And let's review the inputs given. All right, all set to launch the cluster. So yeah, I've clicked on launch cluster. There you go, the cluster got created. So we're all set to create the topics and connectors to proceed further. So to summarize, we've seen how to quickly and easily create Confluent Cloud resources from Azure portal. And we can also use other Azure client interfaces like CLI, SDKs, and PowerShell and Terraform. So let me show you how to leverage this new integration service within the Azure ecosystem. So I'm going to take a use case here, which is a real-time search scenario. So imagine a retail company who aims to provide the best customer experience by enabling real-time search on the product availability. And I've considered a batch system, which is extended to a real-time distributed system, processing the batch data to make it available to the downstream systems in near real time to fulfill the search requirements. So we have a data pipeline between MySQL store and the Redis store, and the Kafka connectors and the clusters are the key enablers to stream data between the data stores. So now let's take a look at the architecture. So like I mentioned, a batch system is extended. A batch process architecture, in fact, is extended to a real-time distributed system running on Azure. So we have a MySQL data store running on Azure. And with the help of fully managed MySQL source connector, the data is uploaded to the Kafka topics. So the Kafka topics are running on Kafka clusters hosted on Confluent Cloud on Azure. There is a consumer app built on Spring Boot running on Azure Spring Cloud, writing data from the Kafka topics to the Azure Redis store. There is a search application built on Spring Boot running on Azure Spring Cloud, processing the search queries. There is also a data pipeline between the Kafka topics and the Azure Data Lake store, which is powered by fully managed ADLS sync connector, which helps with writing data from the Kafka topics to the ADLS store. So with the help of this data pipeline, the users get benefit of correlating the historic data and the real-time data, helps with reporting, analytics, and is also a foundation of a data lake system. So in this demo, I'm going to show the data pipeline between MySQL, Kafka topics, and the Redis store.
It's really interesting how you're mixing and matching the right solution and the right pieces. You have all these kind of like Lego bricks that you get to snap together, and Confluent Cloud is just one piece of those. But as you mentioned before, they're all Azure resources. They're all running in the region that you selected, that you have control of. And I think the other thing that's really exciting that you mentioned is that the management of all these things is using the tools that you already know how to use. So you're really not having to learn how to manage this differently than anything else.
Exactly. Right, Scott. And so all these services are fully managed, and it makes the life of the developer easy. It's all about configuring, and you're all set to get the data pipeline up and running.
Cool. So, I'm excited to see it working.
Yes, same here. And let's see the real-time search in action now. All right. So here we are in the demo zone. And imagine I'm an end user looking and searching for some products. I'm going to use the HTTP REST client available at Visual Studio Code to search for products. So let me go ahead and search for some cool Xbox consoles and click on the request here. Okay, so maybe the inventory is updated, but I don't see the products yet. So let me wear the hat of the retail service provider who updates the pipeline and the inventory. So before that, let me make some checks here. As you see, the Azure services like the Redis instance and the Spring Cloud and the Confluent Organization resource, all of them reside in a single resource group and they're deployed to a single region. Now let's take a look at the Kafka topics to ensure that we see the records when the pipeline is running. Yes, the topics are ready. Now let's make sure that the logs are up and running so that we see the logs when the consumer app is writing records to the Redis store. Okay, the logs are ready. I'm going to use the MySQL workbench to execute the batch process, and the MySQL data store is running on Azure. Okay, we're all set. So let's get started with running the batch process. Okay, as you see, the records are getting inserted. Now let's observe the Kafka topics to see the records getting inserted. So there you go. The data from the MySQL data store is uploaded to the Kafka topics in real time. Now let's look at the logs. Okay, so the logs are also updated. All right, perfect. The data pipeline executed. So let me switch back to the role of the end user.
Before you do that, if I can recap, because I want to make sure that I understand what's going on. So at the top there on line 16, you searched the host to see if there was anything there. And on the right-hand side there on line 10, you can see we returned an empty string indicating that there were no products in the Kafka cloud that have Xbox as a tag. Then you went over into the database tool, you inserted it. We saw in the logs from the Spring application that those inserts occurred, right? You see those change events then were sent off into the real-time streaming system. And then you went into the Confluent Cloud portal, confirmed that those events were seen, and now that data should be available to us in a moment, correct?
Yes, that's right.
Cool, all right, let's see.
Okay, I'm gonna submit the request here. And I have various options, multiple options here to purchase the Xbox console. So I'm gonna have an amazing weekend with my all new Xbox console here.
Interesting, nice. And that happened really quickly. Like there wasn't a batch moment there. We didn't have to wait for an hour for that data to show up. It was instantaneous effectively.
Yes, that's correct.
And is that because it's local, or is that because Kafka is really fast and Confluent Cloud is really fast? Is it a number of factors that because it was all in Azure, it didn't have to go across the world and back in order to be available so quickly? This is real-time streaming, not batch streaming.
Yes. So it's a batch system, which is extended to a real-time streaming, and all of these are running in one Azure region. And thanks to the fully managed connectors from Confluent Cloud, which helps with the streaming data between the source data stores and the target data stores. So this is one of the examples to implement the real-time search, but this can be further extended as per your needs and requirements. Mm-hmm. So as part of next steps, subscribe to the Confluent offer available at Azure Marketplace. And do check out the doc links available at Confluent and Microsoft Docs to learn more and get started with the Confluent Cloud on Azure. And refer to this GitHub repo link to implement the use case. And do let us know your feedback, what worked, what didn't. So yeah, I hope this use case was useful and helpful to get you started to implement the real-time use case using various Azure services and SaaS services as well.
And what kind of things do you have planned for the near future?
Sure, Scott. So we're planning to improve the integration layer by enabling users to create Confluent resources like clusters, topics, and connectors. We're also investigating on extending the integration layer to Azure services like Azure Key Vault to store the API keys and Azure Monitor to monitor the Kafka clusters along with Azure resources. So yeah, watch out the space for more.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Ramya. I am learning how real-time streaming gets faster and easier with Confluent Cloud on Azure today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.